Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. I'm back again and I'm excited. Oh, amazing grace, how sweet it sounds. I'm Donna Jones and this is Be You Saved by UPTV Channel 6. And I'm excited about the Word of God because He is the Word. Hallelujah. He is the Word. And my life has changed. I mean, it's overwhelming on how I'm learning. I'm still learning. Since 1980, I'm still learning the goodness of God, the blood of Jesus, the Holy Spirit, things that I've gone through, I didn't have to go through, but I went through because he said, what kind of spirit you gonna, how you gonna handle this? What kind of steward are you gonna be over this? But I had to get in the Word to find out how to handle it. And as he says, when things are going on, walk away. Jesus walked away. He backed up out of the crowd. They wanted to kill him. He backed up out. He gave us a way of escape. And so now, as I always say, I have to remember in Psalms 126, the Lord has done great things for me. It says for us, but I got to put me there. I got to put Donna Jones there. And we are filled. I'm filled, Donna Jones. I'm filled with joy because I went to do devotion this morning and I'm telling you, I was excited about seeing the people. They're up and ready to go, getting busy about the day. But this morning I said, okay, go, Lord, what do you want me to do? And he was saying, go out there and let them know, hallelujah, that it's all about me and not them, not their neighbors, not the one that's sitting next to them, but it's all about him. Jesus is Lord. And I'm excited. And today I'm just going to tell you, open your mouth and say something and say, Jesus is Lord. Let God know, hallelujah, that you putting him first. And I'm putting him first. I'm remembering that he died on the cross. And so anything that I'm going through and that's making me frustrated and I'm getting frustrated, it's not you. It's something that I'm doing. It's all about me. Misery, I'm making myself misery. Not man, not even the devil. I'm choosing to do the wrong thing or say the wrong thing or be in the wrong place. It's all about me and God and my brother Jesus and the Holy Spirit sitting high and looking low and saying, I know what's going on. I know which direction you need to be going in. But I'm tending to listen to Donna, and that's not good. But I want you to know that God is so awesome, I can't even describe it to you. I can't even explain it. All I know is I'm a happy person. I'm filled with love, peace, and joy. And I'm learning the Galatians 22 and 5. No, I think 5 and 22. I turned that around. But it's Book of Galatians, the fruits of the Spirit. I'm learning how to calm down. I'm learning how in Psalms 37, wait on the Lord and he will renew my mind. So I have to wait. I have to thank him for patience. I'm not asking for no patience because I don't want to go through nothing to find out if I'm patient or not. But he said, be patient. Slow down. Slow your roll. Okay, so that's what I'm doing. I'm slowing my roll. I'm listening to the Word of God. And I'm teaching myself how to stand on the Word of God. And I know there's things that I have gone through, but you know what? Especially last week when I said Valley of Blessings. When you get down and in the valley where you think you're in the valley, just think about and remember what Jesus has done to you. And don't worry about who did it to you. Just think about what Jesus did for you. And let me tell you, it brings love, peace, and joy because he has saved my family, my children. And yes, we all go through something, but how you gonna handle it? You know, are you gonna cuss them out? You gonna fuss? You gonna gossip about them? This is all about, you know, it's almost like when they were in the wilderness, they walked around 40 years when it was only an 11-day journey. 11 days. And they walked around 40 years. But, you know, I didn't hear any bad things going on. I didn't hear about them being raggedy and hungry. I didn't hear about them not having any shoes. Because even though, I can't tell you all the things that they might have done wrong or how they got impatient and then made the calf and all that. But still, God took care of them. Just like he took care of them, he'll take care of us. Just like Abraham went and took his son up on the top of the hill and he was going to sacrifice his son just like Jesus did. He sacrificed his son. I'm telling you, greater is he that is in us than he that's in the world. And so my mission is to encourage you, encourage myself, because if I don't encourage myself, I can't encourage you. So I'm just so overwhelmed with the word of God that's teaching me to be patient, teaching me to remember that I'm filled with love, peace, and joy. I'm filled with goodness. I'm filled with gentleness. I'm filled with righteousness. I'm righteous. I'm worthy. I'm unique. I'm a queen. I'm all that God called me. I'm all that. I'm rich. I'm wealthy. I'm prosperous. I'm successful. I just want you to know all that. And so when we come together, we should be coming together in love. It says here, thy mercies, how tender, how firm to the end, our maker, our defender, our redeemer, and friend. And I'm letting you know Jesus is all that and a bag of chips. He's all that with some whipped cream and some sour cream. He's all that. He like a pork chop to some people, and he's all that to like fish to some other people. I'm telling you, it says, you know, I went on a fast, and the word of God tasted, at that time I was eating steak, and it tastes like a steak. It was a steak and not a hot dog, but you know what? I'm telling you, that's how good he is. It says, oh, taste. See, I'm tasting the word of God. And I'm seeing, it's the old taste and see. So I'm seeing how good he is to me. And you know what? I don't deserve it. All the glory and all the honor goes to him. Because of him, I'm who I am. Because of him, I'm filled up with healing and deliverance and salvation. Because of him, I'm in him and he's in me. Because of him, he is the way, he is truth, and he is life to me. He brings life to me. He brings abundance to me. And I tell you, I go places and I don't want them to see Donna Jones. I want them to see Jesus in me. I couldn't be this way without Christ in me. I believe that I would be mad, sad, and had. But because of him, I don't want to think bad of anybody. I don't want to gossip. I just want to pray for people to seek Christ, seek how good he is, seek him, search him, find out that all our problems, all of our abuse, all the pain, Jesus took it on his body that we would not have to suffer. He took, why am I going to suffer when he took all that, the things that they did to his body, we could not handle. But he took it on that we would have life and have it more abundantly. So stop going on a guilt trip. Stop feeling like God is condemning you. He said he didn't come to condemn you. He came to give you life. So you need to smile. You need to shake somebody's hand. You need to give somebody a holy hug. You need to say hello to somebody. You need to get deeper and deeper in the Word of God. You need to go to Sunday school. You need to go to Bible school, Bible study. You need to go to church. You need to go to prayer. I mean, there's things that we need to do, we don't want to do. The things that we shouldn't be doing, those are the things that we do. Paul said it. The things that I want to do, I don't do. The things that I shouldn't do, I do. Well, you know what? We still got control of that. We still got, I don't have to go over there anymore. I don't have to say that about a person anymore. I just want them to remember that God is good. And it's no such thing as trying him. People say, well, I try him. No, try him. Don't try him. Accept him. You have the choice to leave it alone if you don't want to be a Christian. You have a choice if you don't want to be in the kingdom. I want to be in the kingdom. And when I said, Lord, come into my life, I'm confessing with my mouth that Jesus is Lord. I believe in my heart that you raised Jesus from the dead. It said, I'm saved. I'm in the kingdom. And let me tell you what's in the kingdom. Nothing in the kingdom but love, peace, and joy. See, we want to think of material things, but I want to think about God sitting at the throne looking down at me, saying, give it to her. Let her do that. That's okay. She can handle it. She can handle it. And then I look and I say, okay, think about it. Ecclesiastes tell you, he gives you time to think about what you're about to do. Read Ecclesiastes 3. There's a time for this and a time for that. Ecclesiastes tells me he gives me time to get myself together, time to get my thoughts together. Oh, you can't tell me that you sitting there and you don't have thoughts about what done happened to you, or thoughts about your neighbor, or thoughts on, and you know what they say about assuming. Stop assuming things about people. It ain't none of your business. That's between them and Jesus. Ain't none of your business. What you do is, if you see some things that are not right, fall down on your knees and pray. And so it said here, tucked away in Psalms 126:3, is an even better reminder of God's tender mercies and what they ultimately mean to us. The Lord has done great things for us, and we are filled with joy. What a great verse to take to your heart as we remember Jesus' compassion for us. Oh my God, his compassion. We say we got compassion. We don't have Jesus' compassion. You might have compassion, but it don't take long for us to change. Man changes, Jesus doesn't. He'll never change. Change ain't changing till you change for the better and not for the worse. Hallelujah. But it says, remember his compassion for us at the cross. No man on earth could do that. The difficulties of any given day cannot change the truth that come what may. Our Lord has already shown us unfashionable kindness, unmerited favor, and his love endures forever. Psalms 136:1. And when we have lived through a difficult circumstance and discovered that God was faithful, you didn't have no food, there's a way. You could have went to the soup kitchen. There's places that give out free food. He made a way for us. He made a way for us to have our lights cut on and keeping them on. How to pay that rent. How to pay that mortgage. It's all about God. But we go to the wrong people. We don't go to God and say, Daddy, I need help. I don't know how to do this. Show me. I need you to help me. That's what Jesus did. He said, I got to be about my Father's business. See, he didn't say about my boss's business. He didn't say about my wife's business or my son's business or my daughter's business. He said, I got to be about my father's business because it was nobody else's business but his daddy, because his daddy had the right answer. We keep going to the wrong people. God got the answer. And that's the reason why I'm learning more and more and more. I go and I begin to pray and intercede. Oh, my God. Because, see, I'll just pray for just me, myself, and I. But I want to pray for you. I want to pray for the world. I want to pray for our president and his family. I want to pray for nations and countries. So begin to ask God to fill you with the Holy Ghost. Amen. Fill you that you begin to speak about other people and countries. And sometimes when we're interceding, you can just feel that pain as you intercede. Somebody's being abused. Somebody then got shot. Somebody, and we just praying, Lord, don't let that bullet hit them. I know people have died. I know. And I sometimes think because the saints ain't praying enough. We ain't on our knees enough. We were so conscious about being stylish and wearing the right clothes and the right shoes and looking good before somebody and entertaining instead of praying. God help them. God help them. Hallelujah. And it says, but his kindness to us in the past, when we didn't know no better, he helped us in the past. That we trust him, but his kindness to us in the past helps us trust that he will help us and that we should remember him. Lift him up. Thank him for his mercy. Thank him for his grace, unmerited grace. He said, my grace is sufficient. Not so much as favor here, favor there. Need more money. I need more, a bigger house. I heard a lady say, and a Christian woman, and I thought it was awesome. She said, I remember the time I didn't have anything. Now I got 11 bathrooms. I have a huge home. And I'm thinking, and we complaining because we got two. You know, I'm grateful for two bathrooms. But you know what? I need to rise up too. He's got more than one bathroom. He's got more than two bathrooms for us. But I tell you what, none of that means anything if I don't have Christ. You can have all that you want in the world, but if you don't have Christ, it's going to be like a bucket with holes in it. You're not going to understand why it went away so quickly, but it went through like the water going through. Your water, you can't even make it home with the water because all your water is going to be gone by the time you get to your door because it got holes in it. But with Christ, there are no holes. If we just depend on him and trust him and put our confidence in him. And we think that that's hard, that we're going to miss out. But let me tell you something, what I found out for myself. I didn't find it out through no pastor, no first lady, no evangelist, no prophetess. I found it out for myself that everything that is good that's happening in my life is because I change partners. I change partners from Satan to God. And now I'm remembering how he brought me out of that, how now I'm filled with joy, how I can walk around, whether I'm in your house or my house, I can walk around and I can be the happiest person. Everybody can feel like they down in the valley if they want to. But if I get down in the valley, I'm coming up because I'm filled with blessings. And he's not going to let me stay in that valley. All I got to do is say, Jesus, that's all I got to do. And I'm coming out that valley. And he's going to show me a way on how to fix what's making me feel like I'm down in the valley. He's going to show me. But I got to ask him. Because he says, you have not if you ask not. And I ask all the time. Yes, I ask him everything. Because he said, the joy of the Lord is my strength. And I can go through. I can go through death. I can go through misery. I can go through abuse because you know what? He already took all that. So why am I going to be miserable? Duh. Hello. I'm not going to be. My mom is gone. I can't even talk about another. My son is gone. I don't see any misery in that. I miss them, but I'm not miserable that I can't function. But I'm talking about Donna Jones. Don't call me. And when you see me on the street, don't ask me. I'm talking about me. I don't see any misery. I'm still a happy person. Yes. I don't like to see anyone hurt. But let me tell you, when you can give it back to God, when you can say, Lord, I love you. I don't like what's going on around me, but I love you. I love you because I know that you're going to bring gladness to me. And because it's already there, really. I'm not going to bring it. It's there. I just got to receive it to me that I can enjoy tomorrow. So he said, the song says, you might cry tonight, moan tonight, be miserable tonight, but joy comes in the morning. You know, when things happen to us, I saw and heard a lady say her sister was in a coma for 8 months, but the Holy Ghost told her to get her family and walk around the bed praising God, turning on the radio and putting a word on that she could hear the word and speaking in tongues and praying and not giving up on her. And 8 months later, she woke up out of that coma. See, God wants us to come together. Things don't happen because we're not coming together with one accord. See, you got people in a room, you might have hundreds and hundreds and hundreds and hundreds and hundreds and thousands of people in a room. That doesn't mean we're all with one accord. Things are not happening if we're not with one accord. And we got to speak to Satan and tell him to get out. And we got to come together with the word of God. We've got to agree together and know that we know, hallelujah, that the word works because we work in it. Hallelujah. He didn't die in vain. He died that we would have this life. He died that we could lay hands on people and they get up and walk away. See, we got to come together. See, somebody sitting there, standing there down, that's how come Jesus told him, get out this house. She ain't dead. Get out. All you who are standing around mumbling and grumbling and ain't believing and you're not praying and you're not prayed up. Get out. That's what we got to do. We got to tell them to get out. I told my husband when I went to the hospital, don't let nobody in my room that ain't going to be praying. Don't let them in my room if they turn on the TV. Because I got a radio and I'm hearing the word of God. I got my radio at my bedside, praying, so I can hear the word of God. I got my ears on when I sleep so I can hear the word of God. I need the word. Oh, and I got a good one for you. I have to repent because this point, I'm so happy that I done forgot to put them ears, the word, but I'm going on right on back, put them right on back, you know, because Satan, he comes to steal, kill, and destroy. When you say certain things, he know, she ain't prayed up. Ain't no word in her. Because if it was, she wouldn't say that. She wouldn't be cussing. She wouldn't be fussing. He's going to attack because he needs a body. Rebuke him and curse him to the root and get that word. Everything, people got their ears on, their cell phone. What are you listening to? Let that rain. Is it bringing life to you? Or is it bringing destruction to you? So you bought a pair of shoes for $29. They're going to wear out. The word don't wear out. Oh, that was good. Psst. That was good. And I'm just here to let you know, you didn't bring your own self through. Jesus did. God is the one that got you where you are. And you need to acknowledge him and give him praise, praise, praise him in the car. Shout in the car. I be hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Bless your name. Whoop, whoop. Hallelujah. In my car. Everywhere I go, I give praise to God. And that's what you got to do. You got to give him praise. You got to honor him. And most of you got to say, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. You got to tell him, thank you. That's how good he is. Remember what he done for you. You got food on your table. You got an apartment. You got a home. Hallelujah. You got shelter. You got a pillow. You got a bar of soap. You got water. You got a bed. Hallelujah. You got a stove to cook. You got food on your table. Hallelujah. You got food in the cupboard. You got food in the refrigerator. You got so much meat in your freezer, you need to go and share it. Put it in a bag and take it to somebody else. Think about that woman next door to you. Got 7 kids. Take her some of that meat. And stop being so greedy. Share. That's what Jesus did. He gave us his only begotten son that we would have life. He didn't have to, but he did. And I thank God that he did. And again, God bless you. Receive Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. Be happy and don't worry. Worry ties God's hands. So be happy in Jesus' name. I'm Donna Jones. This is Be You Say By UPTV Channel 6. Love you. And remember, Jesus died. And he rose on the third day for you, you, and you. Amen.